Hello, I am Varsha Unjan and I am a student of Ajinkya Devi Patil University and I'm currently pursuing BTech in Mobile Application and Cloud Technology. Today I'm here to present a job review. So before moving on to the job role, let me give you a brief about the company that I'm working with. I am working with Verificient Technologies and they have four products of their own. The first product is ProctorTrack, which is used by organizations or universities to conduct proctored examinations. The second product is VeriPass, which is again used by either universities or organizations in order to verify the students or employees. The third product is Remote Desk, which is used by organizations to track the activities of their employees and also the performance. The fourth product is Fresh Hire, which is basically used by the students who just pass out in order to find the jobs or internships that are posted by the companies. So now let me give you a brief about my job role. So I am working as a product support specialist and the product that I am working on is ProctorTrack. So as we have just discussed that ProctorTrack is used for conducting proctored examinations. So students do face many difficulties like technical difficulties or non-technical difficulties that they seek help for. So product support specialist is basically a person who helps the students in resolving those queries or resolving the issues that they're facing while taking the proctored examinations through ProctorTrack. So this was just a brief about the company and the job role that I have the privilege to work with. Now let us go a little bit in detail. So there are total four levels of proctoring that are provided by ProctorTrack. In level 1, 2 and 3, the student is not directly connected to a live proctor. Instead, all the desktop screenshots as well as the webcam feed of the student is captured and it is uploaded once they submit the exam and the instructor could later check if the student has made any kind of violations. However, in the level 4 of proctoring, the student is directly connected to a live proctor while giving the actual exam. So in case he has any kind of difficulty or faces any kind of network issues or any kind of test configuration issues, the live proctor is there to help them, pause the exam for them and also resume the exam for them. Here is a detailed data flow diagram which explains the level 4 proctoring provided by ProctorTrack, in which first the student will have to take the onboarding test, which is just a verification test in which the face and ID scan of the student is captured, and there is a practice exam that is just to make the student comfortable with the flow of the proctoring. So this is usually recommended to take 24 to 48 hours before the actual test because it actually takes 4 to 8 hours to be reviewed and it could also be rejected sometimes if the ID scan is not properly captured or the face scan is not actually captured. In that case, the student will have to take the onboarding test again, and until the onboarding test is approved, the student really won't be able to take the actual test. Hence, it is suggested by ProctorTrack to take the test 24 to 48 hours before the actual test. So once the onboarding is approved, the student has the permission to take the actual test. So on the day of the actual test, the student actually can just log on to the ProctorTrack dashboard and go to test. Once he does that, the student will again have to take the face scan and the ID scan, which is again verified. And after that, the student will have to do a room scan, which is again approved by the proctor. Until that is approved, the student won't be able to go any further. After which, the student will have to share the complete screen as well as start proctoring. So once the student does this, the ProctorTrack automatically starts capturing the desktop screenshots as well as the webcam feed. Now once the proctoring is started, the student gets connected to the live proctor and is directed to the actual exam site where he can actually take the test. And once the test is submitted, the student could actually click on end proctoring and quit the app. Now before quitting the app, the data gets uploaded. Now that is all the desktop screenshot and the webcam feed that is captured during the exam. And if there is any kind of difficulty that later comes into picture or any kind of violation, we could actually go through it and instructor has all the access to go through the webcam feed as well as the desktop screenshots. So this was just a detailed data flow diagram of the level 4 of proctoring provided by ProctorTrack. To conclude with, I would like to thank Ajinkya D.Y. Patil University, iNurture, through whom I got introduced to this company, and also for providing jobs, internships, as well as major projects as a part of the subject to the final year students, as this is really important. And also this job has helped me in gaining a lot of knowledge about the proctored examinations and how they work in the back end. Before joining this company, I was really not sure of how all this works, and I am really thankful that I was introduced to this. And thank you so much.